She's fit.
Yeah, I'd fuck her.
Thanks very much.
No, but I would, though. Wouldn't you?
Well, if she's my mum, no.
But if she wasn't?
She is, though, so...
No, but what he's saying is, if she wasn't your mum, would you fuck her?
Oh, are we still doing this?
So you would fuck her?
No!
The Inbetweeners is the definitive study of British adolescent masculinity. It had all embarrassing fury outbursts, hair gel...
What?
Smells quite strongly, too.
Why are you telling this to me now?
I'm just mentioning it. I can see you've got a lot in, that's all.
What? I can't wash it now, can I? I've not got time. God, I don't know why you are like this sometimes.
An in-joke so genuine they spread throughout the country, guaranteeing that no one would ever stand at a bus stop without some tiny jerk putting his head out the window of a Citroën Saxo shouting,
"Bus wankers!"
The Inbetweeners premiered on E4 in 2008, a year after the lawless monster that was Skins. It was created by Ian Morris and Damon Beasley, former flatmates who met while working on Channel 4's 11 o'clock show. While Skins offered a cinematic picture of adolescence we tend to have when we're living through it, when our issues feel so unique and significant that they need their own TV program, The Inbetweeners presented us adolescence as it is. Awful. It's about a group of socially awkward lads who engage in numerous risky exploits while attempting to negotiate adolescence. Their zeal to become adults, however, leads to some amusing circumstances. It's one of the most iconic British sitcoms. The target demographic of the show was 18 to 35-year-olds. However, they may appeal to anyone of any age. One of the generic conventions of sitcoms is that it can be defined as gum. Great writers...
Didn't mean to put him there.
Unforgettable performances.
Oh, fuck.
And memorable characters. And The Inbetweeners has all of that. Before going into talk about The Inbetweeners, here are some of the British and teenage stereotypes. Because that's what the show's about. You know, the first one, always trying to be a man, but copping out. You know, loving to go to the pub for a pint. You know, teenagers are seen as very sex-hungry and they're also bad at sex. They also have bad teeth.
Yeah, of course.
They can be really blunt.
One more at the front.
Sorry?
One more at the front.
Why are there now three people at the front?
Sir, if you could just get...
They've pushed in! We've spent over an hour queuing specifically for the front and they've pushed in!
Sir.
Get them off! Get them off and make them move! Fucking pushing in.
Well, it doesn't matter. We'll sit at the back.
Sir, if you
are they so dumb they think it's okay to push in? Make them move.
Shut up, you plum, and get on the ride.
Sir, it's the last ride of the day. Please get on.
Fucking fine. I'll just get on. I'll just get on and sit at the front next to these inconsiderate assholes.
I'm the worst human being in the world.
Or the complete opposite and just beat around the bush a lot. They complain a lot, you know. Love to drink tea. There's always a violent thug. You know, there's sarcastic, dark comedy and irony are all staples of British humour. There's the stiff upper lip. There's, you know, unsuccessfully buying drugs to impress and a bad first car. Another one would be the boys. The boys isn't necessarily a British stereotype. It's more of a group of people, the boys. Their stereotype is that, you know, there's always someone who's a simp, someone who's always after one person, only one person, and would do anything for them. You know, there's the person who's all talk, the person who's smarter than most, sexually experienced, funny, that can dance, all that sort of thing. And the Inbetweeners characters really do exhibit that. To start off with, we've got Will. He serves as the show's protagonist and narrator. Will is dubbed Briefcase Wanker because he starts his first day at his new school with a briefcase. He's the least popular of the four leaders, receiving extra attention from Mark Donovan and Mr. Gilbert through his own faults. He's shown to be conceited about his own maturity in comparison to state school children, which is a major contributing factor in his verbal abuse. He wears spectacles and carries a briefcase, which makes him an easy target for bullying. He also wears the school blazer in an almost unique way, making him stand out even more. His posh accent, a result of his privileged schooling, is also emphasized. Despite this, a few girls admire him and he even pulls Charlotte Hinchcliffe, earning him the group's reluctant admiration. Jay. He's the most immature and arrogant of the boys. He's also the most rude with a misogynistic viewpoint. He is preoccupied with sex, and practically all of his comments revolve around it. He falsely claims to be the group's most experienced sexual partner. He constantly recounts wild and false stories about his experiences, sexual and otherwise, and gives out very ludicrous advice, such as exaggerating that placing the testicles into the vagina during sex is something some girls like and some don't, demonstrating that he has little comprehension of the subject at hand.
I'm just really good at shagging now, that's all I'm saying.
Bollocks.
Well, how do you do it best then?
Just deep. Try to get really deep, right up to the balls.
And do you put the balls in?
What?
I've heard you got to put the balls in, really, to make it work.
Yeah, can do. Some girls like it, some don't.
He also uses nasty nicknames for the vagina. He is, in reality, the group's least sexually experienced member, frequently relying on pornography for pleasure because he struggles to engage with women. Jay lies about just about everything to make himself seem intriguing, no matter how implausible it is, in addition to his sexual stories. Neil, noted for being the group's dim-witted, polite and gullible good boy. He frequently fails to recognise that he is to blame for the horrible situations he creates, fails to recognise humour, misinterprets things and continually believes Jay's compulsive and blatant lies. Neil's simpler thinking means he is often cheerful and upbeat, and he lacks the selfish and sex preoccupation that the others do. He is usually the group's most sexually experienced member. As seen throughout the series, he is also a talented dancer. Neil is incredibly dense, as seen throughout the series, and will frequently do and say silly things that the others will find absurd. The most prevalent insult directed at his intelligence level is when the others refer to him as a fucking idiot when he does or says something dumb. And last we have Simon. He is seen as one of the group's more level-headed and mature half alongside Will, however he is shown to be readily misled. He looks to be neurotic at times, prone to fits of frenzied cursing at the least provocation, and reacts angrily to the lads' amusing but insulting comments in certain moments. When talking with members of his family, he does similarly. He is bright, yet he lacks common sense and self-assurance. He may be naive, gormless, and docile at times, believing Jay's ludicrous boast of sexual prowess even though he usually seems right through them. He even follows Jay's poor sex advice on occasion. Oh yeah, and he's obsessed with Carly.
Do you wear aftershave now?
Ah, oh, just Lynx.
Oh, that's nice. You come to sociology?
Nah, I'm good here.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll see you later then.
Are you mental? She's so fit. Why don't you just walk to class with her?
I just don't feel like it.
Oh, what's wrong? Did you get hard on because the pretty girl spoke to you?
Can you fuck off?
Hang on, you haven't actually got a stalk on, have you? Oh my God, he's got a boner.
Jay, please.
Oi! Simon's got a boner!
Boner!
Other general conventions of sitcoms are the theme songs. It's in the in-between is it's very catchy and it's very hummable. When it's played, you can recognise what show it is straight away. The locations in the show are pretty generic, you know, they've got the school which it's set in, they've got the pub, their houses, the other girls' houses. They do go on adventures as well, like theme parks, and they make a good time out of it. Everything about the in-betweeners dialogue is funny. Everything they say and do is just relatable as well, because I know that I was also like that in high school. But it's just a laugh, you know, with the boys. So, yeah, I really like the show.